Hello everybody, my name's Walter, and today I have this little item frame controlled enchanting station for you. What do I mean when I say item frame controlled? Well, as you can see at the moment I have zero item bookshelves around this enchanting station, but if I click on this item frame here, I get one bookshelf. If I click it again, I get another, and so on, until we added 7. And now, and that's the nice thing at this little build here, if I click it again, I get an eighth one. And this continues on, until I'm at a total of 15 bookshelves, which then means that I can get a maximum enchanting level of 30. If I click it again, all the bookshelves disappear again, and well, I can start from the beginning. So what will you need if you want to build this little enchanting station here? Well, first you need a couple of building blocks. In my case I'm using stone bricks. Then 18 stairs, 28 slabs, 8 oak wood planks for the looks, then 16 bookshelves. Actually you only need 15, and I'm putting another one in the item frame. Then you will need 2 glowstone blocks. For redstone you'll need 19 sticky pistons, 4 redstone repeaters, 6 comparators, 1 block of redstone, 29 redstone dust, 2 torches, and for special blocks of course you need an enchanting table and an item frame. Okay, so that were the resources. Now let's start with the building. So the first thing you have to do of course is deciding where you want your enchanting station to be. In this case I want my enchanting table to be at this position, and the corner will be in this direction. After you have decided, first place a piece of glowstone or a jack-o'-lantern or another normal block below the position of your enchanting table. The reason I'm using a light emitting block is to lighten up the place, which works because the enchanting table is transparent for light. So after you've placed your enchanting table and the block below, go in the and place 3 normal blocks in the direction of the corner. Then place 5 stairs around like this, and another 2 on this side like this, and another 2 here. Then you go up 3 blocks and place another 9 blocks like this. So next you grab some slabs and fill in the floor and the ceiling. Like this. Then you grab some normal blocks, fill in the ends and the corner. Like this. Now it's time to place some sticky pistons. Go down 1 below the floor and place a row of 4 sticky pistons. Then go around here and place another 4 sticky pistons like this. Then you do the same above the ceiling, but in this case you leave out this sticky piston here. So it's only 3 sticky pistons here, and another 4 here. Then you place some bookshelves above the sticky pistons here and below the sticky pistons up there, like this. Next you grab some wood place one in the below the gap where you left out a sticky piston here, and fill in those backs of the little alcoves you have here. Good. Then you grab an item frame, place it on this block here, and in my case I'm putting a bookshelf in the item frame. You can place any other item you want. Good. Now go back from this block here and put a comparator on top of this block, and as you can see it takes an output from this item frame here. Now go down here and place four blocks and the fifth one in a row like this. Then you go up one and place another five blocks here. Grab a comparator, place it like this, then four redstone wire like this. On those blocks you put some redstone wire too. Then you place another block here with a comparator on top of it, a block behind the comparator, and a bit of redstone here. Then you place another normal block here and place some redstone on top of it too. Then you go and place another three blocks like this, go up one, and finally another two blocks here. Now grab two repeaters, put one on four ticks, the other one leave on one tick, and connect this with some redstone. Then place a sticky piston besides this block here and a normal block in front of it. Now grab a bit of glowstone and place it above this redstone here, place some redstone on top of it, then a normal block above this sticky piston, put a comparator on top of it, then a block in front of the comparator and above the comparator, put some redstone here, then put a normal block here facing into this block here, put a comparator on top of it, place two normal blocks like this, another normal block above this piston here, one block in the corner, then you go up one block, and finally place four blocks besides those four pistons. Then it's time to place some redstone and a comparator like this. Good. Next, place a normal block here with a redstone repeater going into this comparator here. The comparator can be on subtraction mode, it's not really needed. Nevertheless, now it's time to place two torches on those two blocks here. Then place a normal block above this redstone here, put some redstone on top of it, going into a sticky piston facing upwards with a normal block on top of it, another normal block around the corner here, a redstone repeater on this block going into another block, then put some redstone on top of it. Finally, besides this block facing downwards, you place another sticky piston with a redstone block right above below it, and another sticky piston besides this block above the redstone repeater, and a normal block on top of this torch here. And we are done. So it's time for a little test. And voila, you're done. So that was how you can build my item frame controlled enchanting station. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya.